فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
والنظر 12 نحو قوله ضربت وضربنا وضربت وضربت وضربتما وضربتم وضرب وضربتن وضرب وضربت
وضربت
وضربت وضربنا
وضرب
وضرب وضربوا وضربنا.
Now he goes into the 12 types of pronoun, and I already told you it's 12, right? So the first two, which is nahwa, like قولك ضربتُ is للمتكلم وحده, somebody talking by himself, and ضربنا is نحن. So the first one was أنا, the second one was نحن. Good. Then the author goes into ضربت, which is أنت, ضربت, which is أنت, ضربتما, which is أنتما, ضربتم, which is أنتم, ضربتنا, which is أنتن. We finished the 5 مخاطبة, and we finished the 2, which is the متكلم. Then he starts the غائب, which is ضرب, which is هو, ضربت, which is هي, ضربا هما, ضربوا هم, ضربنا هن. Those are the pronouns. All of those لكن that the author mentions here, those he mentioned at that beginning, up to ضربنا, are all, what do you call it, the pronouns that there are. Hey. So we finished that one, inshallah ta'ala. We finished fa'il.
باب المفعول الذي لم يسمى فاعله وهو الاسم المرفوع الذي لم يذكر معه فاعله.
Now the definition that the author gave is that الاسم المرفوع. So it can't be a fa'il, it can't be a harf, it can't be mansub, and it can't be what? مجرور. Okay? It's اسم المرفوع. And then he says الذي لم يذكر معه فاعله, in which its subject wasn't mentioned with it. It was removed. It was removed. The fa'il is removed. هيا.
فإن كان الفعل ماضيا ضم أوله وكسر ما قبل آخره.
So if the ماضي is فإن كان الفعل ماضيا, if the fa'il is ماضي, ضم أوله وكسر ما قبل آخره, like خلق, that's what you say, خلق الإنسان ضعيفا. Are you with me? وإن كان what?
أو إن كان مضارعا ضم أوله وفتح ما قبل آخره.
For example, يفهم, you say يفهم الكتاب. يفهم الكتاب, right? That is if it's a مضارع, you will place a ضمة in the beginning and you place a فتحة to the second last. يفهم الكتاب, right?
وهو على قسمين.
And it's 2 types.
ظاهر ومضمر.
We already spoke about what it means.
فالظاهر نحو قولك ضرب زيد ويضرب زيد وأكرم عم ويكرم عم. والمضمر 12 نحو قولك ضربت وضربنا وضربت وضربت وضربتما وضربتما وضربتم وضربتن
We took all of that before. صح? We don't need to speak about مضمر or ظاهر. We already spoke about it when we were speaking about فاعل. It's the same thing here, right now. هيا.
باب المبتدأ والخبر. المبتدأ هو الاسم المرفوع العالي من العوامل اللفظية. والخبر هو الاسم المرفوع المسند إليه نحو قوله زيد قائم وزيدان قائمان والزيدون قائمون. والمبتدأ قسمان ظاهر ومضمر.
The author here goes المبتدأ. مبتدأ is, the definition he gave is 3 points. الاسم المرفوع, it has to be مرفوع. It's an ism first of all, so it's not a فعل nor is it a حرف. and it is marfu, so it's not masrub wala majrur. He also says al-ari. Ari means what? Ayil khali. Ari means what? Ayil khali. It is stripped from anil awamil al-lafdiyah. It is stripped from al-awamil al-lafdiyah. What does it mean al-awamil al-lafdiyah? It means al-awamil which are asliya. There is no amil that can enter it which is apparent. So what's making a mubtada marfu is something that we can't be seen. It's not lafzi. It's not. Is ibtida'i. The reason why a mubtada is marfu' is because it's beginning, that's why. It's because the sentence starts with it. Not because there's an actual agent where our eyes can see that are in front of it. Does that make sense? It's nothing lafzi, it's ma'nawi. The reason why the mubtada is marfu' is ma'nawi. It's, as you would say, it's not tangible. It's not tangible. Okay? And then he says, wal khabaru, and khabar is, هو الاسم المرفوع. It is the noun which is مرفوع المسند إليه, in which it is attributed to. This thing that you're going to be mentioning in the مبتدأ is going to go back towards the خبر. It's been attributed to the خبر. So there's a condition that the scholars mention. It has to be the same. So the خبر لابد أن يكون مطابقا للمبتدأ. The خبر has to be in accordance to the مبتدأ. So if the mubtada is a mufrad, it has to be a mufrad. If it's a masculine, it has to be masculine. If it's dual, it has to be dual. If it's plural, it has to be plural. Does that make sense? Because you're attributing it to it. So Mahmudun Qa'imun. See how you said Mahmudun Qa'imun. If you say Hindun Qa'imatun, again, to male or female, together, singular, both of them. Al-Amirani, I want to say Hadara. So what do I say? Can I say Al-Amirani Hadara? Can I say that? No, I have to say Al-Amirani Hadirani. Al-Hindani Qa'imatani. I have to make it Tathniya, dual. So if the Mubtada is dual, the Khabar is also dual with it. The same is that if the Mubtada is Jama'a, the Khabar has to be Jama'a. Al-Muslimuna Sajiduna. Al-Hindatun, Al-Hindatun Qa'imatun. Now,
فالظاهر ما تقدم ذكره والمضمر إثنى عشر هي أنا ونحن وأنت وأنت وأنتما وأنتم وأنتن وهو وهي وهما وهم وهن نحو قولك أنا قائم ونحن قائمون وما أشبه ذلك.
The author here, he says the mubtada is two types. Zahir, we already spoke about, he says. ما تقدم ذكره. It's anything that has been spoken about. Mudmar is a pronoun and it's 12. We already spoke about it, right? Which is ana, me. Nahnu, is it we or us? Yeah? We or us? اختلف العلماء. وأنت, وأنت, you, you. Male and female. When I say اختلف العلماء, I mean you guys differ. Yeah? I mean the actual scholars, okay? I mean the scholars in this class. أنا ونحن, صح؟ أنا إن لم تكونوا مثلهم إن لم تكونوا مثلهم فتشبهوا إن التشبه بالكرام فلاحوا. If you're not like them, imitate them. For verily imitating the honorable ones is a virtue itself. Pretend to be like them. So pretend to be scholars, inshallah. Okay. Yunus.
There's scholars in the UK.
Yeah?
There's scholars in the UK.
Ana wa nahnu. Let's copy them at least. Ana wa nahnu. Wa anti wa anti. Anta is you. Anti is you. Are you with me? Are you with me, brothers? Anta is you, masculine. Anti is you, feminine. Wa antuma is you, dual, like it. And you two, both of you. Wa antum is you lot, okay, masculine, like it. Wa antumna is you lot, feminine. Wa huwa, what's huwa? He, right? He, right? Wa hiya is she or her? She. اختلف العلماء. She. وهما is what?
Them.
Them two. وهم? Those. Okay, what about هنا? Feminine they.
The woman they say.
Yeah. It's a weak language. Yeah. Yeah. نحو قولك like your statement أنا قائم I am standing ونحن قائمون and we are standing وما أشبه ذلك and anything like that. So when we look at the word أنت أنت أنتما أنتم أنتن, where's the ضمير in the word? The dhamir is really the word an. All of those forms the word an. The thing that really shows the intent, whether it's tadkir or mu'annath or it's jama' or it's plural, is the ending after that. Are you with me, brothers? Yeah? Wal khabaru?
Wal khabaru qisman.
So he's now going to categorize the khabar into how many types? Two types, hey?
Mufrad
bihi is the opposite of jama'. No, sorry, jumla. Pay attention here. The mufrad sometimes is the opposite of what? Jama. Sometimes the word mufrad is the opposite of a sentence. Are you with me, brothers? The opposite of a tarkib. So, tulab here right now, is it mufrad? According to here, yeah, it is. Because it's just one word. Even that though it is plural in the sense where it's so, but it's just one word. Are you with me, brothers? So the mufrad here, it just means it's a word. Whether that word is a plural, are you with me? But it's just, here is the opposite of jumla. Are you with me, brothers? What would that be in English? Since you're the one who knows it. Hey, yeah? Huh? He likes to correct, hey? No, he doesn't know how to correct. Look at him, confused. Hey, yeah? Who knows?
Yeah, one is looking at
the... Oh, look at him trying. You know, you didn't know a couple of minutes ago. We take it from you. Gulen, do you know? What's the mufrad? That's the opposite of plural. Opposite of sentence.
My singular meaning was singular.
You don't have an opposite. No, but you're using the word singular. Is there a word for it? That's what I'm looking for. Singular in meaning. So what is singular meaning?
That's when it's that verse is mufrad, opposite of jama.
Okay.
When it's opposite of the jumla, it's singular in terms of the wording.
Singular in wording and singular in meaning. Would you guys understand that? Yeah? I told some people I'm teaching at Jumia, they said, oh, in Somali, in Arabic. I said, no, in English. What? How? They're shocked. It's true, I'm shocked. But do you get the point though? The mufrad here is the opposite of jumla, not jama. And then other one, he says ghayra mufrada here means jumla. Okay? And the jumla is four types, ayah?
فالمفرد نحو زيد قائم وغير المفرد أربعة أشياء.
So four types. I'm going to ask you guys later these questions. You have to be very sharp because the quiz is going to come up. The jumla is four types. So when he says غيرو, غيرو, خبر غير مفرد is four types. It's jumla. جار والمجرور, hey?
الجار والمجرور.
Which is, for example, محمد في المنزل. Muhammad's in the house.
والظرف.
And ظرف, which is صالح عندك.
والفعل مع فاعله.
A fi'l with its fa'il, which is محمد فهيم. And for example, is أبوه قائم
نحو قولك زيد في الدار وزيد عندك وزيد قائم أبوه قام أبوه وزيد جاريته داخلة.
He gave you examples of each one, just like I did.
باب العوامل الداخلة عن المبتدأ والخبر.
There's another way that the author could have done it, but he didn't choose to do it, which I think is better. He categorized the خبر into how many? Two, right? Other scholars would have categorized it into three. And they would have said it is mufrad, which is what? The opposite of a sentence. That one we all agree with him on. The second one they would have said is shibhu jumla. It looks like a jumla. It's not fully a sentence, and it's fully not a sentence. It isn't fully a sentence and it's not fully not a sentence. Does that make sense? It's مُذَبْدَبِينَ بَيْنَا ذَلِكَ لَا إِلَهَ أُولَاهِ وَلَا إِلَهَ أُولَاهِ. It's got its legs in the middle. Are you with me, brothers? And that is الظرف and جار المجرور. الظرف and جار المجرور are both شبه جملة. And you know, the reason why they call it شبه جملة is because the جار المجرور can't stand by itself. It's not a sentence, is it? It's a partial sentence. The reason why they say it's partial sentence is because it is two words, but it really can't stand by itself. Whereas the second, third one, which is jumla, is a sentence. It's a sentence. It can mean it can stand independently, regardless of whether you put it into the sentence or not. And that's jumla fi'liya, jumla ismiya. Are you with me? Okay. And that taqseem is good. It gives you a better understanding as well. Yeah?
كان أخواتها وإن وأخواتها وظننت وأخواتها فأما كان أخواتها.
So the author here, rahimahullah, he talks about something called نواسخ. نواسخ are basically, نواسخ are, it basically abrogates. The word نسخ, what's it mean? Abrogation, right? It basically abrogates the previous ruling that were in place. We remember, what did we take? The مبتدأ is مرفوع and the خبر is مرفوع. When these three nawasikh enter the word, they basically abrogate it from its previous ruling. It abrogates it. And it gives it a new, different ruling. So they call nawasikh, abrogators. Does that make sense? And they are three. The first one is kana wa akhawatuha. What does kana wa akhawatuha do to the mubtada? And what does it do to the khabar? What it does to the mubtada is it turns the mubtada into marfu. You guys are not going to say, well, the mubtada was really marfu. No. It took its marfu from him and it gave a new marfu to it. You have to say that. And what was the khabar before? Yeah? What was the khabar before? Marfu, right? When kana enters it, what happens? It makes it mansub. So it changes its ruling and it turns it into mansub. Inna wa akhawatuha. What does it do to the mubtada? It makes it mansub. What does it do to the khabar? It makes it marfu. So it takes the raf' from it and it gives a new raf'. ظَنَّ وَأَخَوَاتُهَا. What does it do? It makes the mubtada mansub and it makes the khabar mansub. Both of them. So we're now going to take these three, inshaAllah ta'ala. Starting with what? كَانَ وَأَخَوَاتُهَا. كَانَ and its sisters.
فأما كان وأخواتها فإنها ترفع الاسم وتنصب الخبر وهي كان وأمسى وأصبح وأضحى وظل وبات وصار وليس وما زال وما أنفك.
لا again you fell into the same problem محمد. ومن انفك ألف الوصل إلى ما آخر يسمى كل شيء هذا
ومن فك وما فتئ وما فرح وما دام
وما برح
وما دام وما تصرف منها نح كان ويكون وكنا وأصبح ويصبح وأصبح تقول كان زيد قائما وليس عمرو شاخص وليس عمرو شاخصا وما أشبه ذلك.
The author here, rahimahullah, goes to كان وأخواتها. كان وأخواتها, when it enters onto the مبتدا خبر, the مبتدا is even its name goes. It's called اسم كان. The خبر is called what? خبر كان. It's not just خبر anymore. It's called خبر كان. Are you with me? So it changes its name and it also changes its ruling. And the author, رحمه الله, mentions 13 verbs, which are the sisters of كان. 13 he mentions them. All of them do the same job. The first one is kana, which is the one that is the biggest sister, and all the others are the sisters and the young sisters. Allah says in the Quran, wa kana rabbuka qadira, wa kana rabbuka. So the rabbu is what? Ismu kana. Qadiran is what? And for me, always when I study, I always remember it like that. I always keep in my head, I say, I say, وَكَانَ اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَيْبِسْتَسِيرُ. That's how I remember it. صح؟ The Quran helps. SubhanAllah, it's ajeeb. The second one is أَمْسَى. Okay, أَمْسَى مَحْمُودٌ نَاجِحًا. أَصْبَحَ. Okay, أَمْسَى shows evening. أَصْبَحَ shows morning. أَصْبَحَ الْبَرْدُ شَدِيدًا. أَضْحَى shows ضُحَى time. أَضْحَى الْمُؤْمِنُ فَائِزًا. ظَلَّ. What does it show? It shows the whole of the day. Okay? So you say, ظَلَّ مُحَمُودٌ فَاهِمًا. Meaning the whole day he was understanding. بَاتَ means night time. It shows night time. Okay? بَاتَ. بَاتَ. I thought it was bigger than what it looked. I had the sound. I'm not scared of it, alhamdulillah. بَاتَ إِسْمَاعِيلُ سَاهِرًا. بَاتَ shows night. صار, it shows تحول والانتقال, to move and to take. صار الماء جليدا. ثامنا, which is the eighth, is ليس. ليس shows negation of the خبر at that particular moment. ليس محمد فاهما, but it only means that moment. Okay, ما زال وما فك وما فتئ وما برح. These four, they all show consistency. Okay, they all mean consistency. And as you can see, all of them, the word ma has to go before it. It can't stand by itself. And as you know, in English language, ushtaqa wastaqa'ida, dual negation shows affirmation, right? Arabic is like that. Nafyu, nafyu, ithbat, right? Nafyu, nafyu, ithbat. Ma zala is nafi. The ma is nafi and zala has ba'na nafi in it. So it means yaqum. So it's bad. Are you with me, brothers? All of them are like that. مَنْ فَكَّ وَمَا فَتِئَ وَمَا بَرِيحَ. All of them are نَفْيُ نَفْيُ إِثْبَاتِ. So when you're reading the Qur'an, you need to turn that into affirmation. And the author then mentions وَمَا دَابَ. مَا دَابَ shows what? It shows مُلَازَمَةُ الْخَبَرِ لِلِسْمِ. Consistency. As Allah said in the Quran, وَأَوْصَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ مَا دُمْتُ حَيًّا. مَا دُمْتُ, as long as I'm alive. All of these three are categorized into three groups. This is very important. I'm going to ask you guys later, inshallah. One is known as كَامِلُ التَّصَرُّفِ. The way it deals is complete. What does it mean, the way it deals is complete? It becomes ماضي مضارع الأمر. Are you with me? كان يكون كن. ماضي مضارع الأمر, right? Some of them are ناقص التصرفي. It's changing from past, present. All of them are verbs, by the way. But all of them, when it comes to changing from past, it's ناقص, it's deficient. Are you with me? It's ناقص التصرفي. Meaning it comes as a ماضي and a مضارع عوني. And that's the form which we mentioned, which is مَازَالَ وَمَنْ فَكِئَ وَمَنْ فَتِئَ وَمَنْ بَرِيحَ. All four of those are ناقص التصرف. It's تصرف is deficient. The third one, which is a type that does not even change at all. Never does it change from once. It's only, it's actually jammed. It's still like that. And that is the word لَيْسَ. And also لَيْسَ. And لَيْسَ is اتفاق النحات. The grammarians all agree that ليس لا تتصرف. It doesn't change. Okay? It doesn't change. So at any form. You can never make it any ma'adi, nor can you make it mudari'. It's ليس. It stays in its form, ليس, which is ma'adi. It can't become mudari' and it can't become amar. It stays the way it is. This is called لا يتصرف أصلا. Yeah? لكن ما دام, ما دام, ما دام على الأصحي, according to the strongest opinion, ما دام is also the same. You put your hand up, sister. What did you want? One and two are كامل التصرف. The first one is كامل التصرف. It turns and tosses all forms. Are you with me? Like كان يكون, هيا يكون. The second one is ناقص التصرف. It can change, but it can only change from ماضي and مضارع. It can't become an أمر. And that's the four that I mentioned, which the word ما goes before it, other than ما دام. ما زال وما فكئ وما فتئ وما برح. All four of those. And the last one is قسم لا يتصرف أصلا, a group, a type that does not change at all. And that's ليس. ليس doesn't change by consent. There's an إجماع on it. And then ما دام according to the strongest opinion. والله أعلم. Salah time is going to come. The people are going to start coming in. It's going to be a bit hard. So let's do our quiz. And we've done more than half anyways. So tomorrow we could finish it nicely, inshallah ta'ala. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.